Sports One. We're in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, one of the best fighting cities in the country. It's time for our main event. You talk about Philadelphia, one of their native sons. He's fighting tonight in the main event. Eric Hunter, the Outlaw. He's taking on Rene Alvarado. You know, for some, it is hard to believe in aliens, let alone know how old they are. But we know an alien is from Philadelphia, and he's celebrating his 50th birthday. Bernard Hopkins, the future Hall of Famer. The resume, it's impressive. Wins over Roy Jones Jr., Felix Trinidad, knockout win over Oscar De La Hoya. And when you talk about undisputed champions, how about the first man to hold four major titles at one time? He did that back in 2004. The oldest fighter to ever win a world championship. And he's the former IBF WBA light heavyweight champion of the world. Paulie, when I say Bernard Hopkins, what comes to mind?
Hall of Fame. The epitome of a Hall of Fame fighter. He's been through generations. It's been old school and new school, and continues to teach the new school how to do it the old school way. Hall of Fame comes to mind right away.
Well, speaking of Hall of Fame and the future Hall of Fame, here he is, Bernard the Alien Hopkins, celebrating his 50th birthday. Let me tell you something. You had a party today.
Yes.
Party last night. I attended a party of yours today. How many birthday parties are you going to have?
Hey, man, it was five so far with five birthday cakes. And you know what? I'm going to put on a couple of pounds, Paulie, this week, because I'm going to enjoy myself. And I'm going to, you know, I'm a bask in the glory, because let me tell you, man, we work hard to become who we become. And let me tell you, when you get there and you get there with flying colors, with a lot of history behind you, I'm blessed.
Let me get into some business here first, because you said you want to fight, one fight at 50, and I thought it was interesting that Carl Froch basically said that now that that fight with Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. is off, he wants to fight you this summer. Is that a fight that's going to happen this summer, you and Carl Froch?
Well, we're working for it to happen, because I respect Carl Froch. He got a legacy, and he wants to add on his legacy before he leaves the sport of boxing. And, you know, that's the perfect fight for me to go back in time. And also, you know, I jumped over middleweight, super middleweight, to get to light heavyweight and made history with Tarver. So now I'm working my way back respectfully, picking up titles in the weight division I skipped over, and that's the super middleweight division. So I'm having the best of all three worlds, the middleweight, the super middleweight, and then the light heavyweight at one time. This is a blessing. This is something never been done. And you know what? Carl Froch, if he's ready, and I know he's ready, he's been around a long time, it would be a great fight, not only for Britain, not only for the United States, for boxing, period. We want to do big fights, and we're going to do big fights. And you know what? Stay tuned. 2015 is going to be a good, good year for boxing, and the fans going to win. And Paulie can echo that.
Hey, man, I've been thinking about Hopkins and Froch.
He's getting ready for something.
I'm thinking Hopkins and Froch. That's an old school fight in the new school. That's exactly what I was talking about. Both guys cut from that old school cloth.
I agree. And, you know, my whole career, I always wanted to fight the best, especially in this division and any other division, because if it's four champions and I have one of the titles, to me, I want to be undisputed. I don't want to be no dispute around the world, amongst writers, amongst critics. When you win one belt, you want the other three. And that's how I've been brought up, Paulie. And that's why I've done it in the middleweight division. That's the past, but it's my history attached to the things I've done. And what way to go out? Going back to a division that I skipped over, super middleweight. I'm there. They better be feared of the alien. At 50. Just because I'm 50, I'm going to make history.
Happy birthday to you.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
Bernard Alien Hopkins. You hear it. He says he's going to fight at 50. It is time for our main event. Paulie Malignaggi, it's going to be a good one. Let's get right to the tail of the tape.
Here we got some numbers here for Eric Hunter and Rene Alvarado. Hunter a little older, 28 years of age. Both weighed in exactly the same. Alvarado has the reach advantage, but he told us in the fighter meetings that he's actually going to look to establish the body attack. So that reach might not come into play if he has his way. He'll probably be fighting from a little bit closer range. So we'll see how things play out, as Hunter will probably be looking to box even if he has a lesser reach.
Well, there he is. Eric the Outlaw Hunter. This is a young man who says a victory tonight puts him back on the national scene, and he hopes a big fight in 2015. All right, both men are in the ring. Let's get the official introduction. Here's Joe Martinez.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, from the 2300 Arena here in Philadelphia, PA, it is time for the main event of the evening. 10 rounds of boxing, this scheduled in the featherweight division. Presented by Oscar De La Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions in association with Johan Promotions. Sponsored by Corona Extra, La Cerveza Más Fina, Mexico. Live it to believe it. O'Reilly Auto parts, better prices every day. And Parks Casino, get lucky in no time. Sanctioned by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission, commissioners in attendance at ringside, Joel Frank and Rudy Battle. The executive director is Greg Serb. The three judges scoring this bout at ringside, David Breslow, Dewey LaRosa, and Steve Weisfeld. And when the bell rings and the action begins, your referee in charge, Gary Rosado. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the judges are ready and the fighters are ready. Philadelphia, make some noise if you are ready! Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white and black, he weighed in officially 125 3/4 pounds. This veteran brings an outstanding record that stands at 21 victories with just 3 defeats and 15 wins coming by way of knockout. Hailing from Managua, Nicaragua, here is Rene El Gemelo Alvarado. And next his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears blue and black and weighed in officially 125 3/4 pounds. His record stands at 18 victories with 3 defeats and 9 big wins coming by way of knockout. Hailing from the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia, PA, here is Eric the Outlaw Hunter. Once again, referee Gary Rosello with the final instructions.
Chair, mouthpiece in, champ. Mouthpiece. Okay. I give you specific detailed instructions in the locker room. I'm only going to tell you 2 things. Protect yourselves at all times. Projete de todo tiempo. Obey my commands at all times. Obey the safe meets instruction de todo tiempo. Touch gloves, bang at the bell.
Well, I don't know how you top our co-main, but Eric Hunter's won 4 of his last fights. Rene Alvarado's won 4 of his last fights. Alvarado believes a win tonight sets him up with a showdown with WBC featherweight champ Johnny Gonzalez. Here we go, round one of our main event. Hunter in the black and blue trunks. Alvarado, the black trunks, the white trim.
Right off the bat, you see Hunter is a southpaw. We're coming out southpaw.
Hunter in our fighter meeting said, listen, Alvarado's a guy. He comes straight forward. My job is to box him.
Alvarado has the body type of a guy you would think would work behind the jab and box at a distance, but he likes to get in there and fight. And like he told us in the fighter meetings, I said earlier, get to the body and bang around. So let's see how he deals with the movement of Hunter. He's cutting the ring off well, though, so far. Keeping Hunter on this side of the ring. Good right hand.
Alvarado was ecstatic to be fighting here in the main event. Says he really wants to make a name for himself here in the States. He felt the only way to do that is get a victory here. Golden Boy live in front of a national audience. Here's a little left hook by Alvarado. Just touches under. And a right by Alvarado.
So far, Hunter's has been trying to find his real estate. Alvarado's landed a couple of good shots in the round.
Minute now here in round one. Alvarado missed with that right hand. More of a feeling out round for Hunter.
Yeah, you want to establish your distance. Make sure you can get in there without getting touched. But Alvarado has these long arms that he can reach you from some weird distances.
Here's a left by Hunter.
Sharp counter.
Seconds here, round one. There, right hand by Hunter. We're starting to get. Welcome back. You're watching Golden Boy live here on Fox Sports One. It's our main event. Eric Hunter in those black and blue trunks taking on Rene Alvarado. It's scheduled for 10. Hunter's from here, from Philadelphia. He's fought 10 times here in his hometown. He's 8-2 in those fights.
Lefty-righty matchups are always a little bit awkward. Sometimes it takes a couple of rounds to get the feel-out process going. Or over with, at least. This definitely has the feel of a tactical, technical fight.
Yeah, which is totally opposite of what Alvarado said. He said, I wanted to pressure him every moment of this fight.
Well, he does, but at the same time, Hunter has such fast hands that Alvarado doesn't just want to walk into a counter. He's been able to touch Hunter here and there. But nothing consistent from either side.
And it looks like he's trying to, every time when Hunter tries to come in with that left hand, try to catch him with that right.
Hunter tried to roll there and counter with the left, but he got smothered. Both guys targeting the body. There's a lot of times with these lefty-righty matchups, when you shoot your power hand as a straight to the body, keeps you out of harm's way of the counter a lot of times. You know? Throwing a straight right hand at a southpaw, if you come up short, you may get hit with a counter left hand. And the opposite way, a left-hander throwing a straight right left hand at a right-hander, you come up short, you're going to get hit with a counter right hand. Sometimes you play safe and go to the body until you find your distance the right way.
Hunter threw a left to the body, followed it up with a right hook. Two big hooks by Alvarado miss. Alvarado's been, basically, he said 2 months preparing for this fight.
Hunter's cut. I don't know if that punch landed or if it was the forearm.
Yeah, there's a cut over that left eye.
I don't know if it was a punch or the forearm that landed when he threw the right hand. Does it seem like he smothered part of that right hand? I don't know if Alvarado was able to extend the right hand properly. Let's see in the replay if we get it.
30 seconds. Here's a right hand by Alvarado.
Right, he's spurned out. He sees the blood and he's motivated.
Now, Hunter switches to the orthodox stance. Blood streams down the face of Eric Hunter. There's a right hand by Alvarado.
Counter.
We'll be back with round three.
Right here, cut, right here.
Back, you watch. watching Golden Boy live here on Fox Sports 1. Third round of our main event. Eric Hunter, he's from Philly. He's in those blue and black trunks. Suffered a nasty cut. They say it was because of a headbutt. From the second round from Rene Alvarado. Alvarado pushing out the jab.
Hunter now staying in the orthodox stance. Which is probably where he's more comfortable in. But the problem with the orthodox stance, now that he's got a cut on his left eye, is the lead eye is the one with the cut. He's been looking sharper since and more comfortable since he got into the right-handed stance.
Continues to pick away at Alvarado. Into the head movement.
Sharp defense. And it seems like a lot of times he's backing up Alvarado, not even throwing punches. His rhythm is, I wouldn't say intimidating Alvarado, but it's making him think.
Tried to catch him with a right hook. And it's Alvarado who catches Hunter. Oh, 1-2 by Hunter.
Yep, nice hook right hand combination.
Under a minute.
Hunter got cut last round. Since he's turned right-handed, though, he seems in a better rhythm.
Yeah, he started this fight with southpaw.
Got to move his head a little bit, though, when Alvarado throws those punches.
Oh, good exchange by both men.
I got the blood flowing on the eye of Hunter.
Big right hand by Alvarado. Around.
Yeah, we might have the replay of where the cut might have come from. See, was that right hand? Oh, that was the overhand, right? I don't know. I think he was already cut off that one. I don't know if that was it, but it's a good right hand over the top nonetheless.
Well, our co-main was one heck of a fight. Michael Perez was victorious. He's with our Jessica Rosales. Jess?
You know, you guys, I don't think there was one person in this venue that was not jumping out of their seats and not one person at home that was not glued to the television. Mike, to say that this fight was exciting is definitely an understatement. Let's talk about what happened out there in the ring.
You know, I went out there and I did what I could do. I mean, the best of my ability. I fought with instincts. I couldn't see from, like, round three on. Actually, with just one eye from round three. And then once I got cut with both eyes, I couldn't really see, that's why I kept rubbing my eyes. And I was just fighting off an instinct, you know, and that's why I kept missing certain shots. But, you know, I did what I had to do, and I got a W, you know.
Definitely, and the jab definitely works for you out there tonight. What was your corner telling you? What were they seeing that you couldn't?
Push the 5-4, you know. They knew what was wrong with my eyes. They knew I couldn't see. So they was just, yo, just put pressure on them and dictate the fight. Don't let them dictate nothing. So I just did what I had to do.
And a big statement was made out there tonight. What do you think that you said with tonight's fight?
Oh, man, that I could bring it. Eyes, no eyes, blind, if I can see, if I cannot see. You know, I can make it happen, you know. And hopefully this could bring big fights for me and push me to the next level.
Congratulations and thanks for the time. Michael, the artist Perez. Guys, we'll send it back to you.
All right, Jess. Michael, congratulations on your victory. Oh, there's a left by Hunter.
And he walked him into that one.
We're in round four of our main event.
If the fight stays tactical, though, you know, it's the advantage of Hunter, because even if he doesn't have the longer arm, he's got the better speed. Good exchange. Brado doing his best, though, to make it into a fight.
We're coming to the halfway point here. Round four. There's a right hand by Hunter.
And beautiful counter. There's a roll on Alvarado's right hand and a short counter right hand of his own. Good skills shown by Hunter. Alvarado's a solid fighter himself, so to have him missing by just a little bit keeps him in position to counter.
Remember, the blood was just streaming from that cut on Hunter's face. The last round, there's a right hand.
And again, that speed of Hunter. And I like the way he changes it up, too. You know, sometimes he'll touch, he'll get into a little shorter rhythm, and then all of a sudden he'll just whip out some fast shots. It's a good change of pace. He's definitely looking much more solid from the right-handed stance.
There's another left hook to Alvarado.
See how he set it up? He came in with a short touch jab first.
And the three-punch combination by Hunter, following up with that. And now we've got blood coming from Alvarado.
Yeah, that was a solid hook. Opened up a cut on Alvarado's eyes. Well,
final 10 seconds of round four. A big round as a left hook by Hunter.
He's finding a home for that hook. Is a replay of the last round. See Alvarado trying to over pursue there, and that's what I mean. Hunter kind of fishes him in. He gets him to over pursue, and then he makes him pay. And there, right there, what I said earlier, a little touch jab first, and then combination behind it. And here's another little short left hand on the inside.
Here we go as we get set for round five of our main event. And one thing we talked about earlier tonight, Paulie, is I love how Golden Boy, hey, look, they match their fighters up.
Yeah.
You know, usually you want to progress a fighter. Hey, let's give him this one. Let's give him an easy fight. Build him up. Golden Boy puts their best against their best. I love this.
Yeah.
Make for competitive fights.
And we were talking about how these guys on the cusp of getting to the next level, and that was those guys were Perez and Hunter, but neither guy's been in an easy fight tonight. And these are the kind of fights where you get by them. Not only are they entertaining, but they'll create and build character. They'll reveal character in your fighter. So if your fighter can overcome these kind of adversity, when he gets to that world-class level, seeing the adversity won't be something that they'd see for the first time.
He's battle tested. Again, we have to apologize for some of the language that comes out of the corners from these trainer and cornermen. Another left hook by Hunter.
Hunter's getting creative.
He pushes Alvarado off him. Now, keep in mind, Hunter's been disqualified in a couple of fights when you look at a couple of his losses.
Yeah, but right there, you know, it was just a little rough stuff on the inside, stuff you see casually in a lot of fights. But he's being creative now with the way he's leading there. That time right there, he led with the lead right hand. What a short counter right hand there. He's doing that consistently as Alvarado. He makes Alvarado reach with his own right hand and then rolls on it and counters with his own right hand instead.
You can see Hunter with the cut.
See those short rolls?
Yeah.
Short defensive moves right there. At times, because they're so short and smooth, he's able to make Alvarado pay for that, for the over pursuit. But it only works if you keep the defense short.
So there's another left. left hook that stuns Alvarado.
And he's found the home for that hook. See, Alvarado's a solid fighter, but he doesn't have the counter-punching ability of Hunter. So inside, he can only make Hunter pay. He doesn't have the ability to make him miss with the same way. He's got the heart and will, as you see here.
30 seconds now here in round five. Here comes Alvarado as he touches Hunter with a right hand. Final seconds here. We'll be back. You're watching Golden Boy Live on Fox Sports 1.
Since the
nice imagine from that last round, Hunter is starting to find a home for his hook on the inside. And there it is again, right there, a short hook as he gets. He gets Alvarado to commit to his own offense and then finds the hook, the openings for the hooks in between it. He's done it a few times tonight.
Round six. So you take a look at the number of punches that have been thrown and landed here up to this point. It's our main event, Eric Hunter. He's from Philadelphia, Rene Alvarado. In this sixth round.
Hunter was looking at the towel. He thought they were throwing the towel in, but all they were doing was wiping down
the corner over there.
Alvarado's corner. Oh, good counter hook.
Yeah, counter hook by Hunter. And another one.
That's calm in the ring, though, when you start to see stuff that's not going on around you. Oh, good body shot.
Another left to the body by Hunter. Halfway through round six now.
So I love how Hunter keeps all the defense short, right in the, he never really leaves the pocket, and he's right there, so he can counter you if he's able to get off. Otherwise, it'll keep you missing and keep you frustrated, because it's like you got him right in front of you, but you still can't hit him the way you want to.
He's got good movement, and he rolls.
Yeah,
very
good upper body movement, look. So it's frustrating for a guy like Alvarado, who's got him right in front of him. You think you got him where you want him, but you just can't never touch him the right way.
See exactly what Paulie was talking about right there.
And then he'll go from this little smooth rhythm, almost a slow motion rhythm, all of a sudden he'll rip off a fast combination of fast hands. So good. I like the change of pace, the change of rhythm he does.
As we hit the 30-second mark here in round six.
From this, and it's almost a nonchalant stance, and then he'll just be able to get off shots.
He missed with that left hook.
And he's got Alvarado down his own offense.
That's the round. Paulie, I want you to pack your bags because we're heading down south here. Next Monday, we're going to have a couple of margaritas, some Tex-Mex. We're going to be in San Antonio.
Some warm weather.
Oh, absolutely. As Walkie Juarez will be the headliner January 26th right here on Fox Sports 1. Well, on Sunday, he's one of the most decorated coaches in history with the 11 Final Four appearances, four NCAA championships, now Hall of Famer. Coach K, he's gunning for 1,000 Talk about wins as he leads Duke into the Moles Hallow Grounds and Sports in Madison Square Garden. He'll face St. John's. Coverage begins Sunday, 1:30 Eastern, only on Fox. This is our main event. We're in Philadelphia, 2300 Arena. Eric Hunter, he's from Philly. Rene Alvarado.
Going back to the southpaw stance here.
Tried to catch Alvarado coming in. Missed with that left hook. See Hunter. He's just looking to parry that jab of Alvarado.
Yeah, a lot of times when it's a lefty-righty matchup, you try to dominate the lead hand. If you can dominate the lead hand, you'll have the upper hand in the exchanges. So sometimes you get a little wrestling, a little parrying between the lead hands of both fighters.
Alvarado continues to bang at the guard.
Yeah, he's able to pepper Hunter better when Hunter's in the southpaw stance because his defensive moves aren't as smooth. He just has to cover up, so force him to go back to the right-handed stance. And that's what shows you Hunter is much more comfortable out of this stance. Defensively, his balance is a lot better from the right-handed stance.
Halfway through round seven.
Again,
double hook by Hunter.
Right hand, too.
There's a right to the body.
In this stance, you can just see such a major difference in Hunter. There might be times or fights where, you know what, he might be better served to fight out of the southpaw stance, but this fight, it's very clear and obvious the difference. The way he dominates out of the right-handed stance.
Now he's got the hands down low.
Hey, just changing the look there. People might take that as cockiness, but it's more confidence and also a change of the look. You're giving Alvarado a different look. And he's got to readjust to the target.
Here, Alvarado gets a little warning, pushing down Hunter's head.
Check left hook there.
And Hunter pops Alvarado with a jab here at the end of the round. Well, in our opener, you saw one of the young talents of Golden Boy, Lamont Roach Jr. Boy, he got a stoppage. He's with our Jessica Rosales.
All right, you guys, and I don't know if you know this, but he actually made his pro debut on one of Bernard Hopkins' cards, now making his TV debut on Bernard Hopkins' birthday celebration show. What's going on with that, Lamont?
Golden Boy has given me wonderful opportunities. I made my pro debut on Bernard Hopkins' card. He fought Shumanov. I fought a four-round fight. You know, I fought real good. And now it's his birthday, and I got a knockout. So he told me to give him his gift yesterday at the weigh-in, so I gave it to him.
All right, and you gave him a good gift today, too, with that win. Now, you were expecting to go six rounds, stopped it in the fourth. How do you feel about the performance out there tonight, and what did you learn from that?
I feel that I had a good performance. You know, I took my time. I didn't rush the knockout. I see that he didn't have enough to be in there with me, so I took advantage of that. I picked it up as each round went. And, you know, my coach said it's about time, so that's what I did.
Yeah, and that was one thing that really stood out about you was being poised, being calm. Where did that come from?
I have a very seasoned coach. I have a nice team behind me. You know, we've been preparing for this moment, you know what I'm saying, and more to come.
Right, we're excited to see it. We'll send it back to you guys.
All right, Jess, thank you very much. Who says family can't get together and do big things in boxing?
Yeah.
Mont Roach, of course, managed by his father, trained by his cousin.
Absolutely, a very mature young man. And when we went to the fighter meetings, you could just tell he had a very mature team around them as well. So you could see where he gets it from.
Absolutely. A short right hand there by Eric Hunter here in our main event. We're in the eighth round.
Again, Hunter showing a lot of skill here, man. I mean, this Alvarado, oh.
There's a right hand by Alvarado.
Alvarado's not an easy guy to deal with. He's a pretty good fighter in his own right, but Hunter is just in such a groove, in such a rhythm. I mean, he's seeing everything right now.
Well, Hunter's talked a lot about being victorious tonight because he says this year he wants big fights.
Yeah, the way he looks right now, man. I mean, he's ready, I think, for any featherweight in the world. At least be in the ring with them for sure.
As we come to the halfway point of round eight.
Trying to target the body now.
Yeah. Hunter's trying to catch him.
He just gets impatient and jumping with that lead hook at this point. And that's a sign of frustration. Hunter has him missing. He can't catch him the way he wants to. And you start to see things like lunging shots from the outside and whatnot. Those are signs of frustration on the part of Alvarado. He's just hitting him where he can. He hit him in the back there. He's trying to hit whatever he can at this
whenever
point.
Whatever I can get my hands on.
His Hunter cannot let it just not let him land.
Under a minute now here in the eighth round. There was a right to the body by Hunter.
And you see how that was started. A little touch jab to the top first, snap jab to this body, and then the right hand behind it. Again, I love the change of speed on his offense, you know, the change of pace. And you start the combination slow. Sometimes it's sharp counters there. You start out the combination slow and then pick up the speed so that your opponent doesn't get your trajectory on the timing of it.
That cut that Hunter sustained early in the fight in round two really has not been a factor here in the later rounds.
Not at all. Some action from that last round. See the counter uppercut there by Hunter. Hunter got touched just slightly with that right hand, but again, this goes to show you sometimes you make a guy miss by so little. The right hand might even touch you. The shot might even just barely touch you, but obviously it didn't touch him enough to divert the counter from getting off. And that, you know, that means he probably just barely skimmed off his face. And that's a lot of times the best part of defense is when you're defensively real sharp, you make the guy miss by ever so little and you're able to get the full commitment, and that way you can put everything on the counter and get it to land.
Alvarado starts round nine off with a straight right hand. Hunter comes back, pops him with the left, does it again.
Alvarado might have got a pep talk in that corner. Trying to come out fast here in this round. But again, he's got to get the confidence to get off. Because he's lost that confidence a little bit with the sharp counterpunching and the defense.
Like that.
Of Hunter, right there. Exactly. Exactly, Brian. Sharp check hook on the way in.
Minute gone here in round nine. Oh, Alvarado.
At the hook. Yeah, he countered the counter there.
Yes.
I don't even know if he did it on purpose, but Hunter was going to counter the right hand. And Alvarado came back with his own hook off of Hunter's right hand.
Hey. 90 seconds left in round nine. Alvarado getting frustrated.
Hunter's been less busy this round. He's trying to change the real estate and trying to get the overcommitment from Alvarado. Alvarado's been more careful when he does get off offensively this round, though.
You know, Alvarado was very adamant that he was coming here to pressure every moment of the fight.
But it's hard. It's hard to keep that pressure on a guy that makes you miss and makes you pay.
Like that, right hand.
You know, that'll make you doubt your own offense. When you know a guy can make you miss and make you pay, it'll make you doubt whether you want to get off those punches. People say, oh, just be busy. But sometimes the busier you are, the more you pay for it.
Yep. And you can see in the face and the eyes of Alvarado, the frustration.
Yep, and there, Hunter didn't make him pay, but all those punches missed ever so closely. And it's just frustrating, as Alvarado's just almost there every time, but most of the time he's not there. Trying to short little right hand counter right there. Again, just rolling on Alvarado's right hand and countering with his own right hand. He's actually done that a lot tonight off that right hand of Alvarado. There's a different look, a little further look. But again, rolls on the right hand. You get the commitment because Alvarado's now got to turn his body to throw his own right hand. And therefore, you can make the counter nice and short and touch it. He did all the work for you. All you got to do is to roll your hips and the right hand will land.
I think the corner says it all. Look at the difference of the corners, how calm and cool and collected they are in Hunter's corner. And they were throwing water at Alvarado, very adamant. You can tell, then they were like, listen.
Yeah, because at this point, all you can do is motivate your fighter if you're Alvarado's corner to try to get the knockout. But it's a catch-22 because Hunter's just walking into more and more traps. So the more you work a lot of times with a guy like Hunter, the more you're going to get hit. So it's not about working harder. It's about working smarter. And when you only got 3 minutes left to do it,
yeah.
I don't know if you got much choices.
Yep.
Many choices.
And he's gonna have to come out and take some chances. Hunter has made him pay when he does. Continues to catch him with that check left hook. Used a head movement. He's rolled the punches.
Kind of watching himself on the big screen. He's so calm in there. Oh,
he caught Alvarado there.
Again, catching him off the hook. Tried even this round, but it rolls the short moves of Hunter and then the counters. The counters over the top with that right hand with a hook. And Hunter's shown the ability to counter Alvarado's right hand from both sides. He's countered the right hand with his own right hand, and at times he's countered the right hand with a check left hook as well. So a lot of times Alvarado doesn't even know where it's coming from. He just knows that the counters are coming.
We are under a minute now. Continues to try to find the target to no avail.
Hey, think what Hunter's looking at the screen for is probably how much time left in the round.
Yeah. Keeps looking up at that screen, wondering how much time is left in the round. There again, that check left hook by Hunter. Under 20 seconds. Seconds of this fight. Oh, ew, a right hand by Hunter.
And the hook for good measure.
And that's the fight. When we come back, the judge's official decision. This is Golden Boy Live.
If you can rock it.
All right, fellas, appreciate it. We'll be locked and loaded watching you guys tonight. Of course, our main event just finished up. Take a look at the final punch stats. Eric Hunter, Rene Alvarado. Hunter connect 30% of his punches through over 360 punches, landed 112 of them. Alvarado landed under 100 for 22%. Let's get the official decision. Here's Joe Martinez.
Rounds we go to the judges, and here are the totals. Judge Steve Weisfeld has it 98-92. Judges David Braslow and Dewey La Rosa 97-93. For your winner by unanimous decision, Eric the Outlaw Hunter.
No surprise there as Philly's Eric Hunter gets the unanimous decision. Paulie, give me your final thoughts on what you saw tonight. Lamont Roach, Michael Perez, Eric Hunter.
Saw some great fights, some great talents, some really good skills from Roach, Hunter, some all-out war from Acosta and Perez, both skilled, but in a different kind of manner. I like what Hunter just showed at the end of the fight, during the whole fight. Real sharp.
And how about Bernard Hopkins saying he wants to fight Carl Froch? For Jessica Gonzalez, Paulie Malignaggi, I'm Brian Custer. Let's go out to our studios in Los Angeles. Fox Sports Live rolls on.